Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream.
Is life a dream? Are we merely the figment of our own imagination? Outside the simulation, I think we're living in a kind of utopia. And by you, I mean the real you. The thing that resides inside your avatar, which is the meat suit which you accidentally thought is the real you. And in the reality above this one, you get bored of living in utopia. Because let's face it, utopia sounds nice, but it'd be more boring than listening to James Corden.
Let's suppose that you were able every night to dream any dream you wanted to dream. And that you could, for example, have the power within one night to dream 75 years of time. Or any length of time you wanted to have. And you would naturally, as you began on this adventure of dreams, you would fulfill all your wishes. You would have every kind of pleasure you could conceive. And after several nights of 75 years of total pleasure each, you would say, well, that was pretty great. But now let's have a surprise. Let's have a dream which isn't under control. Well, something is going to happen to me that I don't know what it's going to be. And you would dig that and come out of that and say, wow, that was a close shave, wasn't it? And then you would get more and more adventurous, and you would make further and further out gambles as to what you would dream. And finally, you would dream where you are now. You would dream the dream of living the life that you are actually living today. That would be within the infinite multiplicity of choices you would have, of playing that you weren't God. Because the whole nature of the Godhead, according to this idea, is to play that he's not. The first thing he says to himself is, man, get lost. Because he gives himself away. The nature of love is self-abandonment, not clinging to oneself. Throwing yourself out, as in, for example, in basketball, you're always getting rid of the ball. You say to the other fellow, have a ball. See? And that keeps things moving. That's the nature of life. So in this idea then, everybody is fundamentally the ultimate reality. Not God in a politically kingly sense, but God in the sense of being the self, the deep down basic whatever there is. And you're all that. Only you're pretending you're not.
Because in a utopia, everything would be done for you, and everything would be free, because there would be no money, so you wouldn't need to work or do anything that you don't want to do. And I think that utopia misses the point of what it means to be human. Human beings don't want everything done for them. They think they do, but they don't. Human beings like meaning. Human beings need meaning and purpose. They need to make it for themselves, make their own mistakes, and win their own games, which is why they can live out their wicked fantasies, their gluttony, their sexual tastes and desires, their workaholic ideals, or just plain hardship inside this simulation. Because where we're really from, there ain't none of that. I think that the real you, your soul, spirit, whatever, is just bored, and it has no challenge or obstacles. The real you is bored because it has no challenge or obstacles. I think that the real you is just bored. By real you, I mean your soul, spirit, or whatever. Imagine playing a video game and it gives you everything that you need straight away on level one. That's not a game, is it? And the society in which you exist in the future, in this utopia, let's say, has developed detailed photorealistic simulations. This could be 50 to 100 years into our future. And so, bored, because everything's been bloody done for you, you seek adventure where you can lose yourself inside a game. It's like actually getting to play as the GTA character on a video game, or the lead role in a TV series or film. Imagine actually getting to be Walter White from birth to death. See, hear, taste, touch, be Walter White, and everything is scripted. and you even get to cook meth, you fucking sicko. Or you could say, alright, fine, I've done all that, I've been Walter White, I've been everything else. Now I want an experience that is completely unscripted. I want to play as a character that I don't want to know what it's going to be. I want a complete surprise. It'd be like pressing the randomise button on a video game. And that is why you are here now. At some point, you have decided to play as you. Perhaps you've been many people throughout time, fulfilling all the desires of existence that your soul or real player has cared to desire. Through our eyes, the universe is perceiving itself. Through our ears, the universe is listening to its harmonies. We are the witnesses through which the universe becomes conscious of its glory and of its magnificence. Alan Watts. Some people are quite preoccupied with the apparent darkness or badness in this world. But the only reason we know about goodness is because of the badness. This is the yin yang. You can't have the light without the dark. And so when people say to me, why is there all this destruction, badness and wickedness in the world? In that whingy sort of tone, you know? I say, well, it's twofold. Number one, because where you come from, there is no badness. And it's bloody boring. So you came here specifically to experience it. And number two, so that you will more appreciate the good. Living inside this holographic simulated virtual reality existence allows you to lose yourself in a hyper-realistic video game and play the part of finding yourself, discovering what you really are. And where you are now is exactly where you're meant to be. So when you feel lost in life, that's completely purposeful. You were meant to lose yourself, so you get to experience what losing yourself feels like. You see? Some people then say, well, if this life isn't real, if it's all just a virtual reality construction, then it has no meaning. Firstly, how do you define real? Real is just what you come to know as real. Of course, if all you know is shadows on the wall, then you would regard those as real. Secondly, just because something is not real in the sense that we thought it was, doesn't mean that we cannot live out fulfilling lives. In fact, I would argue that you are living a way more fulfilling life inside this simulation than you are in the one in Utopia. Because, in a sense, you are a god, experiencing itself subjectively as a fractal of eternal consciousness inside this holographic simulated reality, hidden inside a meat suit, playing the role of you, forgetting what you are, to experience the most far out adventures across the universes of space and time, and all of it in the blink of an eye. Life is a dream, a simulated one.
But then, oh, life could be a dream, life could be a dream. Good.